The topic is interpretation of z-scores. All right, so let's read the definition. A z-score measures the distance of a data value from the mean in standard deviation. A z is equal y minus y bar over s. So what does that mean? If we have a value that's bigger than the mean, for example, this y, then the z-score will be y minus y bar, right here, over s. But since y is bigger than y bar, than the mean, then the z-score will be positive. Now, if a y value is on the left or smaller than the mean, then if the value is smaller than the mean, then the z value will be negative, right? So let's read this problem. So the first example is, it says, suppose your statistics professor report test grades as z-scores, and you got a z-score of 220 on an exam. Write a sentence explaining what that means. So what does So look at the interpretation right here. A z-score measures the distance of a data value from the mean in standard deviations. So what does this tell us? It tells us that the test grade, let me write it down, for your test grade, is 2.20 standard deviation, right here. Standard deviations. Is it above the mean or below the mean? Since it's positive, 2.20 is positive, then we say above the mean. If it was negative, then we say below the mean. So I think that would be the next example. One of the authors has an adopted grandson whose birth family members are very short. After examining him at his two-year checkup, the boy's pediatrician said that the z-score for his height relative to American two-year-olds was -1.88. Write a sentence explaining what does that mean. So here is the case where it's negative. So what we're talking about? We're talking about the boy's height. So the boy's height is 1.88 standard deviations . Is it above or below? Since it's negative, we're gonna say below the mean. But of course it makes sense. If it's on the left, smaller than the mean, it's gonna be negative. And if it's the z-score, and if it's above the mean, the z-score will be positive. And that's it for this example.